welcome to my channel, Court the Nurse Realtor, and I am Court. If you are new to my channel, hey boy, hey, hey girl, hey, welcome, welcome. And if you are an oldie but a goldie, hey boo, welcome back. I'm so glad you came back to join me. And as my oldie but goldies know, if you see me in a scrubs and a stethoscope, it is going to be a nurse-related video. And this video in particular is about the best nursing advice I ever received so far in my career. So if you are a new nurse and you like, child, what advice can someone give me starting out? If you are an old nurse and you like, girl, what nursing advice somebody gave you? Because, child, maybe I need to know the tea. Or if you just want to be plain old nosy, go ahead and stay tuned, because this video is going to be tea pack. Well, my tea at least. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm trying to get to 3,000 subscribers, so go ahead and click that like button and ring my bell. Ring my bell, my bell. Ring-a-ling-a-ling. And you know what? I want to say thank you to those who have already hit that subscribe button. It does not go unnoticed. I appreciate y'all so much. I appreciate the comments. I appreciate the likes. All that you are doing to support this channel, may God bless y'all tenfold. So let's get into this video. Okay, guys, so I want to give you three of the best nursing advice or tips that I ever got. And they may not be so technical, like, oh, put the Foley this way or this. Actually, I had a good one. But anyway, you know, just may not be technical, but it has been advice that has sustained me throughout my career. So I'm going to do from 3 to 1 to what I feel like is the best nursing advice I ever got. The third best nursing advice that I ever got was always keep 2 badges. So I had an older nurse. When I kind of first started out, she was like, girl, always keep you 2 badges because, number one, one may slow down and you may need to work another one and pick up your shifts to sustain your household. Or one may make you mad and you might be like, forget this, child, I ain't gotta work here. And you could politely make your resignation and you still have another income. And I think that that was really good advice to a new nurse, because we all going into nursing, I'm not gonna say we all, but I will speak for myself. I had this like tunnel vision, like, oh my gosh, I have this job. I have to like keep this job. I can't really say too much. Da-da-da-da-da. I don't wanna rock the boat. But when one thing that nurses, registered nurses, LPNs, you all need to know is that you are valuable. And I know at times it seems like you are another number, but understand that people can't just clock in and be like, bro, I am a RN, I am an LPN, honey, it takes work. So understand that you are a commodity, and if it's something that you are not jiving with in your current position, or it's just like you've been going through trials at this particular job, keep you 2 badges so you can go to the other one and still make your check. Okay? Okay. So anyway, my second best piece of nursing advice is always treat your patients as you would want someone to treat you or your family member. Let me tell you something that has always kept me in perspective and kept me in, kept things in perspective and has always kept me empathetic, because let me tell you, I have been in a lot of situations where I've seen other healthcare professionals treat different populations, demographics, less than, and I've never been that type of nurse, because let me tell you something, if it's me or if it's my family member, and we all got family members in on the spectrum of class or finances or whatever the case may be, and I don't care which end of that spectrum my family member's on, if you better be treating my family member correct, or my friend. So I always have kept that perspective, because I know one thing, I don't want no, and let me tell you, the Bible say you reap what you sow, and it, you know, it's true. So I have seen where it has come back on people later on in life. Healthcare professionals that I worked with later on, when it's their time, they get the short end of the stick. But you always got to be mindful of how you treat people. And if somebody's being disrespectful to you or disgusting to you, you need to understand that you don't have to take abuse, and you need to handle that way accordingly. But if you are just going through the day and maybe you're having a bad mood, remember, baby, you could always be on the other side of that bed or your family member. So that's the second best nursing advice. And for number one, my number one top nursing advice is Know your policies and your procedures. Let me tell y'all something. This piece of nursing advice has saved me countless times within my nursing career. Let me give you an example. I used to work, you know, prior to doing case management utilization review, I was a PACU nurse. I worked in a outpatient, it was in a hospital, but it was an outpatient department where we recovered, second phase two recovery, and you could float, whatever the case may be. We also did outpatient procedures. So this particular day, we were doing outpatient, we were really busy, we were doing outpatient procedures, and I had to do a phlebotomy. So what a phlebotomy is, it's basically like some patients have, I want to call it some patients have an extra amount of blood or extra thick blood, and they are required to come in and you take off one unit of blood. Okay, this is something that I have only done maybe a couple of times, but it's a procedure that gets done in an outpatient setting. It's nothing too major about it. It's like a vacuum bottle. You kind of poke the spigot in there, and then you just kind of do a phlebotomy. You would do like an AC stick or wherever you can really get, because these people get stuck a lot. It's hard to get a stick, which leads me to my point. This particular lady had been getting this procedure done over time, and she is a heart stick. So she did have a port. So we had a newer manager at the time who was very just focused on finances and getting things done and processing these patients, and with not really considering the repercussions of doing things in the wrong way. So of course this was my patient, and I told her, I said, listen, we had like three people stick are the best, and I ain't gonna say, you know, I was one of them, okay, and we could not get sister girl. So she was like, well, I got a port, do you want to try that? I did not know if it was possible to use this vacuum device on a port, because these things have a suction, they have like a PCI or kind of like a pressure limit. So what I did was I went to look in our policy and procedures. I could not find it there. I looked for the actual on the port device that she said she had, because you know they have the little power band bracelets. I couldn't find it there. I went so far as to look on the infusion nurses code of ethics and policies and procedures. So I had exhausted all of these resources and was unable to find out if this was something that I should be doing as a nurse and for the particular device. And I really didn't get a safe enough answer. Child, my manager flipped his wig, honey. Okay, he was going off. He was like, you need to do this. I don't understand why. What's the big deal? Yada, 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 this and that. And I said, well, you know what? You got RN behind your name too. You could definitely come and do it. You could come and do it, because me, I don't care who you call. You could call the nursing supervisor. You could call whomever. But this girl right here will not be doing that on this patient. My guy didn't do a thing. He was like, well, I guess you could send her back to the doctor's office. You guess right. Because guess what, guys? If something would have happened to that lady, it would have been on my shoulders, okay? It would have been on me. And nobody was going to back me up, because I didn't have a policy and I didn't have a procedure. I didn't have anything in the lipid cot. I didn't have anything on the manufacturer's site. I didn't have anything on the governing nursing body of this type of specialty. So I was out on the limb, and it would have been my behind, okay? So let me tell you, that is a story to show you. Always know your policy and procedures, and if you can't figure it out, you need to go to your charge nurse. You need to exhaust all resources prior to doing it, and if you cannot find a resource, don't do it. Let me give you another example of how the policy and procedures saved me. So in the same facility, they had thick nurses that were certified to do certain things within the facility, and one of those things was administering cath flow. You had to be signed off, checked off, this whole procedure before you were able to administer cath flow or even check cath flow on patients. You had to have go through this whole process. So anyway, I used to pre-op and post-op, or recover, I should say, interventional radiology patients, and that was some things that they would do. They would administer the cath flow, especially to your renal patients, your PARP patients, whatever the case may be. And in this particular scenario, the interventional radiology nurse, she administered the cath flow. She brought the patient back to our unit, and then was like, okay, they're supposed to come back and check, right? Pull back, make sure it's cath flow, do whatever they're supposed to do, right? She got caught up in the time frame in that particular facility. The policy had a certain time frame. So she, Miss Mel, picks up the phone and calls me and said, well, can you just check it? I was like, no, that's not my specialty. I'm not signed off to do it. I cannot check it. You gave it, you need to come back and check it. My girl went as far as the nursing administrator on duty about me not and looking back and doing a drawback on this particular cath flow. But that was okay, because you know what your girl did? I went right to my computer. I had patients and I knew they were coming, and I knew they was gonna come to the unit and try to get me to do this. So what I did was I went on the computer really quick. I pulled the policy and procedure. I highlighted where it said the nurse needed to be certified, and I left it on the desk. And I told the unit secretary, when they come looking for me, go ahead, show them what I left them. And so said, so done. I went in with my patient. By the time I came back out, my unit secretary me said, gosh, how did you know they was gonna come? When they came, they was like, where's Courtney? And I just told them, oh, Courtney's in a room with a patient, but she left you this. Highlighted, when they saw it, they turned around and she had to come back there and do the cath flow. Let me tell y'all something. Their policy and procedure say nobody couldn't tell me anything. That is in black and white. This is what your facility says. If you want it done, you do it. Understand, my friends, the policy and procedures, the Lippincott manuals, the governing certification body of these nursing specialties are what is going to save your behind when it comes to a court of law, when it comes to your facility ethics, all of that stuff. So always, always know your policies and procedures. So that is my tea for the day. That is my nursing advice. That's the three best pieces of nursing advice I ever got. Drop down low if you have some good nursing advice. I would love to hear what y'all have learned over the years, and let me know if this is helpful. But most of all, I love you, but God, He loves you so much more. God bless you.